Welcome to episode 1 of Hearing Tech News, the Mark Trong. Today we'll be talking about Apple's release of iOS 14 and the accessibility features they are baking into iOS to help increase accessibility to communication and technology. I just want to give a huge shout out to Abram Bailey at Hearing Tracker for his article on AirPods Pro become hearing aids in iOS 14. So the new feature, which is really important for people with hearing difficulties and hearing impairments, is Headphone Accommodations. They say that this feature is designed to amplify soft sounds and adjust certain frequencies for individuals' hearing. We're not really sure how they're going to do this, whether they're going to do a normal tone test or hearing assessment in some way, but they say this is meant to help in music, movies, phone calls, and podcasts, and try and make them sound more crisp and clear to your individual hearing. The really important part, though, is they say that it can be also used in transparency mode with AirPod Pros, making quiet voices more audible and tuning the environment around them to your hearing needs. Companies like Nuheara and Wear&Hear are already doing this kind of work in the hearable space to try and amplify sound around you, but I think it's really important that Apple gets into the game, because I think they're going to be changing up the market just like what they did for the Bluetooth headset market. They've completely revolutionized the Bluetooth headset market. It's been totally redone. Before the AirPods Pro, there were barely any options, and now there are more options, cheaper options, and everyone's getting into Bluetooth headset game. Just imagine in 6 to 12 months, the number of options people with hearing losses and hearing impairments and people who struggle in background noise are going to be having because of this new innovation. People with hearing impairments have been waiting years for more options. They've only had hearing aids as an option or seeing an audiologist. And I think, although it's controversial, now that a major player, Apple, has stepped up to the plate, real change will be happening. I know other companies such as Google with their sound amplifier and Chattable have been trying sound amplification through their phone, but having a lot of issues with latency. But now that Apple has stepped up, they're investing the money, they're investing the capital to develop the technology, I think we're really going to be seeing more options in the future. Just have a look at what Apple has done to the Bluetooth headset market. They just sold 60 million AirPods in 2019, grabbing 71% of total wireless headphone revenue. Just look at this graph. They take up 71% of the market. Samsung doesn't even come close. Beats, Bose, Jabra, Huawei, all of them combined don't even scratch Apple's market share. So it's going to be really interesting to see what happens to the hearing healthcare industry now that Apple has stepped up to the plate, and how hearing technology will be forced to innovate and change because of this innovation. So keep an eye on the space. Leave any questions you have in the comments below, and I'll try and answer all your questions. I think it's going to be a really interesting space to watch, and I'm really excited for how Apple is going to revolutionize the hearable market.